The extraordinary is now becoming the norm for Marc Márquez, but even this weekend he exceeded the new boundaries that he set upon himself. The now 8-time world champion went from crashing back down to earth with an impact of over 26 G on Friday, to then being on top of the world just 48 hours later. It all came after his Thai Grand Prix started in typical Márquez style.
As usual, up to speed in no time at all, the world champion. He's currently fastest by almost a second.
This morning we stayed in a good way, the first part of the practice, but then we had a big crash.
The world champion-elect, rattled, shaken third. That Repsol Honda is completely demolished. He's just about getting to his feet.
That really has taken the wind out of his sails. Not something I have to say I've seen in a long time.
Yeah, he had a big crash, as you all saw, but fortunately he's okay. We went to the medical center to check everything, to the hospital, and they did an MRI and everything looks fine, and fortunately he's okay, but nothing to be worried of, and we were lucky for today.
Yeah, maybe the tires were not ready, maybe I was on the dirty place, we don't know exactly, because I was much slower, obviously, from the fast lap, but yeah, I lose the rear, I had a big high side, a long time without high side. In the beginning it was hard, because I couldn't breathe, but then step by step I get better. Already when I arrived in the medical center, I was okay. I went out in the FP2 with, I knew that my body was okay, of course painful, but important to save or to escape from that crash in a good way.
They're going to be thankful that their man is okay. He's taken a serious blow there, Marc Márquez. He's going to be feeling incredibly battered and bruised for the remainder of this weekend. Let's hope that he is going to be able to try and start Sunday's race and try and win the 2019 MotoGP World Championship. He's certainly going to have to do it the hard way.
But Marc Márquez would make that task even harder on Saturday by having his first two crash weekend since the French Grand Prix.
Márquez, he's down! He's down
he's
here!
He's turn five, he's gone down right in front of our commentary box window. That's Q2 over for Marc Márquez. He will not be pole, but he'll probably stick on that front row. There is Marc Márquez. He walks away, thumbs up. Nowhere near as big a smash as what he had at turn seven in FP1 yesterday, but Márquez will not be taking pole here in Buriram.
The mistake was not turn five, the mistake was turn four. In the exit of turn four, I had a small shaking, and then with that shaking, the patch of the brakes opened, and then when I arrived at the breakpoint, was no brakes. And yeah, I was braking less than usual. No, about the physical conditions, of course I have some pain in the body, but it's not a problem for tomorrow. This one was an easy crash, not a big damage.
So no further harm done ahead of Sunday's main event, and any fears that his monster high side on Friday might limit the world champion's powers were quickly put to bed.
We're on the last lap. Will it be a rookie win, a maiden win? Will it be a Márquez win on his way to that 8th world crown? Onto the back straight we go. He's got brilliant drive, Marc Márquez. He's in the slipstream. He will now pull over to the left again. Now he's going to go on the brakes. He's really late. Is he going to get that? Repsol Honda stopped.
He's
going in deep. He's done it. He's through.
He's a little bit wide, but he's going to cut it back to the apex. Marc Márquez then hits the front. He's just going to be a classic late attack from Márquez to clinch the 2019 MotoGP world title. Quartararo lining up for attack. Márquez, is he going to hang on? He's going to be world champion shortly, but it's all about the last corner.
Here comes Fabio Quartararo up the inside. Márquez knows it's coming. He can't stop it. It's the cutback. The checkered flag is out.
He's done it.
He wins in Thailand, and he is the 8-time world champion. What a rumble here in Buriram.
Until the last lap, I was pushing. I never think about the championship, just I was thinking about the race. And yeah, then when I crossed the line, when I arrived, especially with all the Repsol on the team, that they did an amazing job this year, I was very happy. Dreams come true with Dolphin Club, a nice celebration, so yeah, happy, and now time to enjoy this nice victory.
We start the weekend with very good luck, because maybe we are in the hospital in this moment, no? But in the end, the life, he say that the message is you have lucky, not injured, and today we catch the goal, and this is the most important.
I don't know how this team can be stopped, but only thing I know is that we will try that nobody stopped us.
As the easy position was to finish second, win the title, and that's all. But this is the point. No, Mark is the guy what he liked to win. He have angry to get the victories, to get the championship, and this is the difference, you know. He enjoy. He know if he can try, he will try, and then this is the best. When you have a rider like that, is amazing, you know. For that reason, I say he is almost perfect.
He was on the deck and in hospital on Friday morning, and we thought it was all over, and he comes back to win. He is the master of MotoGP.
We'll be right back.